Well, here we are in Boston. It's 1984, an interesting year, but it's 2 years after I've made that copyright on the cosmic wheel, which is chapter 6 in the book, and it deals with anti-gravity. This is Omnivideo, and I'm making a proposal to Omnivideo to have them shoot the movie. This is Ray Barnes. He's on my side. I know him from Roxbury, West Northwest. And here's me and RJ. RJ's a big producer there, James Connolly, and he's going to be, and this behind him is Jim Barzano, and this is Carolyn, who's totally on my side as usual. We're already working as busy as could be at Harvard on this Case of the Nines, which is chapter 3 of the book, but we're taking a little time off here to see if we can this is Robert Barzano. He's probably the man who's going to make the decision. Well, here I am with the papers. The script is written out on these, and I have all the drawings. I've got all the work done on this project that I've been doing in my spare time as the passion that I have on movie production, and also as I do the legal brief, and I'm also working on the calendar at the same time. But I'm in my prime, as you can see, and I'm working at a New York minute here. So it's an easy sell. You've read the script, hopefully, and you've seen that it's all about the invention of what people would call anti-gravity. But here's RJ and James, and he's really trying to get together from a long stay in Vietnam. He had a rough tour. So I've got the pictures drawn out, and Barzano is get really interested in it. It's just though it's a big production. It's Hollywood, really, and for Boston, these are video artists, and this is really a motion picture script here. But I've already been to Draper Labs, and we talked about it's really not anti-gravity. It's a centrifugal force field that surrounds a flying saucer that makes it stabilize to and have the Earth orbit away from it. So you really think that you're moving, but you're really stabilizing and the Earth's orbiting away from you, and so you can play on all the motions in the universe, the immediate solar system, and just stabilize off of them and travel around like that. And if spinning the Milky Way will get you from one star to the next, and you can do it at a rather fast speed because the universe is really moving very, very fast, and if you stabilize, it's like if you stood in one spot, the rotation of the world, and you were off, would be moving at I think about 1,000 miles an hour, that's the surface of the Earth. So the technology. It's really a patent, and it's the beginning of what's going to be string theory because. The rotation mathematics really discovers that is a proposal to say what's the center of a black hole is really the mass is just accelerated to the point where it can have the acceleration times the mass is an equal equation. So the top part, it's like a vortex, which the top of the vortex spins very slow, but the center, which is very fine, spins very fast, but they're always in equilibrium as far as the speed times the mass. Well, here's Moon again. I'm really getting away from the movie, and Moon is on my side for sure. And here's Carolyn doing the final cell there. Good luck. She's with Ray, and this is my team. And good luck, because